Hi friends, welcome back to Mentrix Max channel. Today we are going to study a new chapter, a new topic from the chapter pair of linear equation in two variables. In 9th classes we have studied how to solve a linear equation in one variable. So in this chapter we will study how to solve the equations that relating with equations in two variables. Suppose if we went for a shopping and buy a 4 chocolates and we paid a sum of 20 rupees to the shopkeeper, then what is this? Then what will be the rate of a 1 chocolate? That's for that, let us consider that x is a rate or cost of a 1 chocolate. And how much we buy? We buy 4 chocolates. So 4x equal to 20. Then what will be the value of 1 chocolate? That is x. X is equal to 20 by 4. Because what? When we bring this left hand side variables or constant to the right hand side, what will be the equation? Then the simple or the operation relating with this equation will be changing. Here it is multiplication, so when it comes to the right hand side it changes to division. So what is the value of x? X is equal to 5. Then what is the cost of 1 chocolate? The cost of 1 chocolate is 5 rupees. So this is the equation that is in one variable. Here what is this? Here x minus 4 equal to 0. Here how many variables there? Only one variable is present, so one variable and one constant. So x minus 4 is equal to 0. Then what will be the value of x? X is equal to 4, because when we change the number, when the place of the constant from one, that is LHS side, to RHS side, then its simple will be changing. Here the simple is subtraction symbol. So when it comes to the RHS side, it changes to plus simple. So what is the value of x? Value is x is equal to 4. So this equation is, this type of linear equation is, we call it as one variable. Linear equation in one variable. We have studied how to solve this type of equation in one variable in our 9th standard. Here in 10th standard, we are going to study how to solve a linear equation in two variables. Suppose again, I will show and give an example. Because when we are dealing with the mathematics, when we connect our day-to-day problems or the mathematical problems to our day-to-day lives, it will be easy for our calculation. So I will show you how to link this one. Because in pair of linear equation, two variables, we can link that one in our day-to-day lives. I will show you how to say. Suppose we and our friends, okay, we friends has gone for a shopping and we buy a cool drinks, 5 cool drinks, plus then also we buy 5 pencils or 4 pencils. So then we paid a total of rupees 60. Then what will be the cost of 1 pencil and 1 cool drinks? So if such situation is arises, then we have to know how to solve a linear equation in two variables. So what is that? I will show you how we can approach this. Here, one bite, 5 cold drinks plus 4 pencil. Then what? How much we paid? We paid total sum of 16 rupees. If we thought to divide the sum among each share or share among ourselves, then we have to know what is the value of x, what is the value of why. So for that we have to know how to solve a linear equation in two variables. Linear equation in two variables, what is that? What is the definition? An equation of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is called linear equation in two variables x and y, where a not equal to 0, b not equal to 0. Here a, b, c are real numbers. So what is this? Here it defines that whenever these problems ax plus by plus c equal to 0, it is defined as equation in two variables where we have to certain condition. What is that condition? That the condition is that here coefficient of x, a coefficient of y, b, and this coefficient c, that should be a real numbers, and this x and y, it should be a two variables. So if that such cases arises, we define an equation as the form equation in two variables. What is an example? Let me show you an example. 3x plus 2y equal to 8. It is and in the form of ax plus by equal to c. Here again 4x plus y equal to 9. Here what is this 4? Here 1, 9. It is also real numbers. X, y is an variables. So this is an example of equation in two variables. There are two methods for solving linear equation in two variables. One is graphical method, other is algebraic method. Here, first in this video, let us study how to solve linear equation two variables using algebraic method. Before that, we have to know how many types of equation, how many types of solution is there when we solve the equations. There are two types of equations. That is, in when we are solving two variables, we get two types of equation. That is, consistent equation and inconsistent equation. So, what is consistent equation? When we got at least one solution, then at least one solution, then such type of equation is called consistent equation. If there is no solutions for an equation, then such solution is called inconsistent equation. Inconsistent equation, there are two types of solution. That means what? Inconsistent, at least one solution means what? If we get one solution, one permanent numbers or one solution for x and y, then such solution, that is unique solution, if we get a unique solution, then such a solution is called unique solution. Then such consistent solution is unique solution. If we got many solution, then such is called infinitely many solution for the consistent. So I will show an examples that shows an equations with unique solution. 2x plus y equal to 4. It is an equation with unique solution. Again, x plus 2y equal to 5. Then a linear equation two variable with infinitely many solution is, I will show an example, x plus 2y equal to 4. 2x plus 4y equal to 8. This is an equation with many solution. Next, what's the solution? An equation with no solution is x plus y equal to 3, 2x plus 2y equal to 5. Suppose we have got a equation such as a1x plus b1y equal to c1 and a2x plus b2y equal to c2. This is a two equation, that is pair of linear equation in two variables. So what is the case one? I will show you a case one. That is, what is the coefficient of here x? What is the coefficient of x is, that is a1 and a2, and coefficient of y b1 and b2. When we find these ratios, or when we divide the ratios of the coefficient, that is a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. That is, the coefficient of x should not be equal to coefficient of y. That is, coefficient of one variable should not be equal to the another variables of a linear equation. Then if such condition is exist, that is, if such condition is shown, then we can define the pair of linear equation is consistent with unique solution. That is, a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Then that is consistence with unique solution. So let me show you an example. Here, 2x plus y equal to 4. X plus 2y equal to 5. What is the coefficient of x? That is 2 and here 1. Then what is the coefficient of y? Here 1 and here 2. Let me compare the coefficients of x and y. That is 2 by 1 and 1 by 2. Whether the coefficients, that is a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2? Absolutely no. 2 by 1 is not only equal to 1 by 2. It is not equal to 1 by 2. 2 by 1 is not equal to 1 by 2. That means coefficient of x is not equal to coefficient of y. Already shown a pair of linear equation two variables, that is a1 x plus b1 y equal to c1 and a2 x plus b2 y equal to c2. If in case 2, what is the condition? If the three equate, when we equate the coefficient of x, that is a1 by a2, coefficient of y b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. That is, if three terms, that is three real numbers are equals, that is when we divide three real numbers are equal, then we can define such an equation is consistent with infinitely many solutions. Such pair of linear equations has many solutions. That is a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. Let me show you an examples. Here, x plus 2y equal to 4. 2x plus 4y equal to 8. What is the coefficient of here x? That is 1. Here 2. That is 1 by 2. Here 2 by 4. 2 by 4 means what? 2 by 4 means what is the ratio of 2 by 4? Simplest ratio is 2 by 4 means 1 by 2. And here last. And last, what is that? 4 by 8. What is ratio 4 by 8 means? 1 by 2. Here, everything. When we equate everything, what is the equation? Ay by a2 is equal to 1 by 2. And b1 by b2 is equal to 2 by 4. c1 by c2 is equal to 4 by 8. a1 by a2, b1 by b2, c1 by 2. Everything is, when we equate these terms, then what is the simple ratio? That is 1 by 2. So when we equate these terms, we get answered as 1 by 2. These three terms are equal. Then if such cases are recent, we can say the pair of linear equation two variable has consistence with infinite solution. Infinite many solution is there. Third case. Suppose if given a pair of linear equation, that is a1 x plus b1 y equal to c1, a2 x plus b2 y equal to c2. This is a pair of linear equation. Then if the coefficient of x is equal to coefficient of y, and which is not equal to the ratios of coefficient of the ratios of constant term, that is c1 by c2, then such condition is arisen, then we can define this equation as inconsistent with no solution. That is a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2, which is not equal to c1 by c2. Let me show an example. Here x plus y equal to 3, 2x plus 2y equal to 5. Here, what is the coefficient of x? That is 1. Coefficient of here this x? That is 2. What is the coefficient of y? 1. Coefficient of here y? That is 2. Then coefficient that is constant term 3 and constant term 5. When we find the ratios, that is a1 by a2 is equal to 1 by 2, b1 by b2 is equal to 1 by 2, and c1 by c2, that is ratios of the constant term is 3 by 5. That means what? Here a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, but which is not equal to c1 by c2. So what is that? If such an equation is we got, then we can simply, when we are looking at the equation itself, we can say that it is an inconsistent solution with no solution. So when we look at that solution, equation equals, we can know that it has no solution. So we don't want to find the solution for that equations.